Oh, hello, it's me, Mr. PSX, telling you why COPPA might not be such a good thing. Let's get into it.
Hello, peoples, it's Mr. PSX here, recording this in stereo since Mano is apparently quiet and I don't have any patience for fixing that kind of crap. Now, COPPA, to get some context, November 12th, I had a premiere of Extra Item Glitch, the movie, the sequel, in a place. Later that day, I had an upload and it went live. Then I got some sleep at the evening. The context to that is that my rhythm stuff is screwed a bit, you get the idea. I woke up at night pretty much and I refreshed my videos thing and well, I saw this thing over here and I thought to myself, what is this COPPA screwing everything? I look at learn more and what immediately set me off is that they say that you are required to set future and existing videos as made for kids or not. And I get a bit confused. Apparently I also have to use YouTube Studio, which in fact is incompatible with the browser I'm using on XP for this stuff. Makes sense. And I take a look at the page, looking at stuff, and see that what gets disabled if something is for kids and all that. Yes, I find this thing where, this page where we determine if the content is made for kids, and the thing here seems to be that if it has something that kids might like or something it's made for them, if they can see it and they can watch it, you know, it's made for them, and that doesn't make sense. According to the FTC's guidance on COPPA, a video is child-directed, which we call made for kids, if children are the primary audience based on the factors described below. So that makes sense. Children are not the primary audience, but the video is still directed to children based on the factors below. I am confused by this, in fact. When deciding whether or not your channel or video is made for kids, you should consider various factors, including subject matter of the video. I can see that. Whether children are your intended or actual audience for the video. Right. Whether the video includes child actors or models. Nope. I don't have those. Whether the video includes characters, celebrities, or toys that appeal to children, including animated characters or cartoon figures. Is this one of these things, if it's drawn, or is cartoons, it's for kids or something? That doesn't make any sense. Of it is more kid-friendly, of the video is intended for children to understand. Whether the video includes activities that appeal to children, such as play acting, simple songs or games, or early education. I don't know about that. Whether the video includes some stories or poems for children. Any other information you may have to help determine a video's audience, like empirical evidence of the video story. What does that mean? How old is a kid? Under the age of 13 apparently in the US, may differ in countries. What is this? And it seriously seems like if kids can watch it, it's made for them, and this doesn't make sense. Now my app is some are for kids, some is not, and there doesn't seem to be that middle ground at all. Kids can watch my stuff, but it's not made for them specifically. And if some of these things seen on the page here are in a video, can I tick that it's not for kids when it's not and just happens to have a few things that, you know, might have some animated stuff or, you know, their own stuff as a part of it in the one thing that as a whole may not be suitable at all to them? Can I tick no to that? Because if I can, well, this is a pretty screwed up thing. What are they trying to achieve? Now, I don't know anything about mobile, other than that the mobile-like interfaces, they are invading everywhere. I think those icons only that tell you nothing, and nothing tells you anything, and everything is more difficult than it was and should be and stuff, but apparently there's an app that called YouTube Kids already, and is that not enough? I mean, is this one of these cases of parents are not parents these days anymore? I mean, it's not our problem if kids watch crap that's not made for them, you know? I don't like this idea of doing content for certain people just because, you know? I'm more into this thing of I do my stuff, you either like it or you don't like it, you know? And this goes pretty much against it. It's not just EU trying to throw things with their stuff, but we are against US as well. We have YouTube Kids already, that should be enough. Parents should start parenting again. There's all kinds of stuff. It's pretty much the job of those parents to, you know, do their things to protect. We'll see what comes out of this. I'm a bit afraid at the moment, partly because of future plans that might be ruined for this. What if my content is applicable to a wide audience, but not kids specifically? As the creator, you know your content best. If you intended to reach a kid audience, it's likely that your video is made for kids. What the actual OMM they counterate by saying that the fact that a kid is featured in a video does not necessarily mean that the video is made for kids. See, this is confusing, but I've seen kids acting adult movies, but in safe scenes, so there's that, but wait, are these confusing in purpose to make us consult lawyers and those costs? And if we fail to comply, well, things go downhill pretty fast. I can see why people are worried. I am as well. And obviously, I did the recording for this in November 13th and constructed the video in the following days. How delayed this is in the whole, it remains to be seen. But hopefully I'll work on it and figure all this stuff out. And yes, good night and goodbye.